Welcome back students. Today in this class we are going to study how to convert a ternary operator statement in Java to if else statement and an if else statement in Java back to ternary operator statement. So this type of question will be asked for your board exam. So we have already studied about ternary operator. So ternary operator is a decision making statement in Java. So it is also known as conditional operator, and the other name of ternary operator is conditional assignment. So it is a substitute for the if else control statement in Java. So when we are using this ternary operator, it requires three expressions. The syntax of the ternary operator is conditional expression, then question mark, expression 1, colon, expression 2, and after that semicolon. Here you can see that here in conditional expression we are checking the condition. Okay. So the condition is given before the question mark. It is enclosed in parentheses. If the condition is true, then true case will be executed first. So expression 1 is the true case. So the statement that coming after question mark, that is a true case. Then if this condition is false, so false part will be executed. So after the true case, we will put a colon. Then after that, we will write expression 2. So expression 2 here acts as the false part. So this is a true, expression 1 is a true case, expression 2 will be the false case. So here you can see that when we are using this if else statement, so by executing it, we can see that it requires 3 or 4 lines if else. That is, if condition, then true case statement will be executed, else false part will be. So a total of 4 lines are required when we are using if else statement. But when we are using ternary operators, the entire thing can be done in single line. That is, condition checking, true case and false case, all things are done in single line. So let's see it with an example. Here A greater than B, this is a condition we are checking. So it is the value of this particular condition is assigned to the variable max. Max equal A greater than B. So if this is a condition, so a condition should be always enclosed in parentheses. So if this condition is true, true case will be executed first. The value of true case will be executed first. So the value A, here A acts as the true case part, then B acts as the false case part. Here you can see that this true case and false case are separated by a colon. So the part that comes after question mark, that is a true case, and the part that comes after colon, that is a false case. So don't forget to put the semicolon after the termination of this statement. So this is the question. Rewrite the following program using if else statement. So here you can see that double com for commission equals sales greater than 5000. So this is the condition, then a question mark, sales into 5/100 colon 0. So here in the statement you can see that question mark, colon, then semicolon. So this is a ternary operator. So we want to convert this ternary operator to if else. So it's very easy. So the part that comes in parenthesis, so before question mark, this is the condition. So this is our condition. So after checking this condition and after the question mark, the part that comes after question mark, so this up to colon, so this is the true part of this condition, and the part that comes after colon, this is the false part of the condition. So let's see how to convert this particular statement in ternary operator to if else statement. So it's very simple. If, so what is the condition? Sales greater than 1500. This is the condition. So if this condition is true, what is the true case? Sales into 5/100. This is a true case. And after that, put a semicolon. Don't forget to put the semicolon. Else. So which is a false case? If this condition is false, the part that comes after that, this is the false part, zero. So here you can see that we have used the variable count of double tape. So inside this value, we are going to store the true case and false case value. So write it also, double count equal sales into 5/100. Similarly, or here also double count equal zero. So this is a way of converting a statement in ternary operator to if else. So let's see another question. Rewrite the following statement using if else statement. Cap grade equal total mark greater than 450. Question mark A B. So here you can see that don't forget this is character type, character value. So the true case, this is the condition. So here we have used the ternary operator, question mark, colon, semicolon. So ternary operator, then, so this is the condition comes that comes inside parenthesis condition. So the part that comes before colon and question mark, that is known as true case. The part that comes after colon, that is the false case. So the value of true and false is going to store in the variable char grade. So it's very simple. Simply convert if total mark greater than 450. So this is the condition. If this condition is true, then true case will be executed first. So don't forget to write this char grade equal A else false part. Char grade equal B. So this is the way of converting a statement in ternary operator to if else. So don't forget to write this thing with its data type. So it's sometimes the data type may not be given. So from the answer itself, we will know the data type. So suppose this char is not given. So here you can see that the value is in char type. So include it. Okay. Next, rewrite the following program segment using if else statement instead of nested ternary operator. So the question is given, nested ternary operator is given. So this type of question will also be asked. So here you can see that this is a condition. Question mark, then colon, again a question mark, colon, semicolon. So multiple conditions are there. So this is the first condition. So here we have to use if. If this condition. If this condition is true, this is the true case. Isn't it? We know that. So the part that comes after this, this is the false case of this condition. So here this is also a condition. Use else for this. Else if. So for this condition, this is the true case and this is the false case. So it's very simple to convert it using nested if. So in the question they have given if else, but we know that this is a nested ternary operator format. So we want to convert it to nested if statement. So if, what is the first condition? If mark greater than 90. So what is the true part? A. So it is going to store in the variable grade, that is char grade equal A. Then put a semicolon. Again, false case of this condition. So here we have to use else if. Else if mark greater than or equal to 90. If this condition is true, what is the true part? B is the true part, C is the false part. So it is going to store the variable grade. So char grade equal B. So for this condition, the else part is else char grade equal C. So this is the answer for this question. Next, we are going to study convert, rewrite the following program segment using ternary operator. So the host is given in if else. We want to convert it by using ternary operator. So the answer should be, you know that when we are converting a if else statement to ternary operator, the answer should be in one line. So what is the condition? Sales greater than equal to 100. This is the condition. And after that, put it in parentheses. Then put a question mark. If this condition is true, what is the true part? This is the true part. This is the false part. So here you can say double discount. This is the common value. Inside this value, we are going to store the true and false part. So before this condition, the same double discount. Double discount equal. So what is the true part? Sales into 0.25. This is a true piece. Sorry, this is a true piece. And after that, put a colon. So what is the false part? This is the false part. This part. That is, after that, put a colon. Not semicolon. Colon. Sales into 0.1. After that, put a semicolon. So this is the answer for this statement. So let's see one more question. Rewrite the following program segment using ternary operator. Int age double pension. If age greater than 60, pension equal 18,500.50. Else pension equals 0.0. So here the statement is given in if else. We want to convert it to ternary operator. So we know that the answer should be in single line. But here you can see that there are two variable declaration are there. Int age double pension. So declare that variable declaration also in the answer. So solution, int age, declare it. So we know that we are going to store the result in the variable pension. So it's of double type. So in the next line, double pension. So the false part and true part answer is going to store in this variable double pension. Okay, equal to then write our condition, that is age greater than 60. If this condition is true, what is the true part? Pension equal. So double pension equal. That is the way we are reading. So the answer is 18,500.50. This is the true case. Then put a colon. What is the false part or else part of this condition? So this is the false part, pension equal. That is double pension equal. That is the way we are reading. So 0.0. So this is the answer. So it's very simple to convert a statement in if else to ternary and ternary back to if else. I hope this content is clear for you. So let's continue the class with a new topic